Hello students, welcome to the course of mechanical system design, in which we are learning about design of cylinders and pressure vessels. In this lecture we will be learning about the thin cylinders. Cylinders are mechanical devices used for storing, receiving, processing or carrying the fluids. For example, in case of pressure vessels, storage vessels, pipes, cylinders of hydraulic or pneumatic systems and cylinders of an IC engine, etc. Pressure vessels are cylinders which are storing or carrying fluid at a pressure typically higher than atmospheric pressures. Cylinders are designed using the formulae derived from the first principle, whereas pressure vessels are designed using the formulae available in standard applicable codes released by BIS, that is Bureau of Indian Standards, ASME or German code or Japanese code, etc. On the basis of relative thickness of the cylinders with respect to the inner diameter, they can be divided into thin cylinders or thick cylinders. If the ratio of inner diameter to the thickness of cylinder is greater than 20, then it is known as thin cylinders, and if the ratio of inner diameter of the cylinder to the thickness is less than or equal to 20, then it is known as thick cylinder. In order to understand the stresses in the cylinder, we have to look into various modes in which a cylinder can fail. Let us consider a thin cylinder having inner diameter di, thickness t and length l. It is subjected to an internal pressure pi. As per Pascal's law, the pressure will act in all the directions with equal magnitude. Let us try to understand each mode of failure one by one. The first failure mode is along the length of the cylinder. In this failure mode, the cylinder will fail like a cucumber in which a knife is passing along the axis of a cucumber. The cause of this failure is the circumferential stress. When the cylinder is failing, the equilibrium of forces is given in this equation. In the left hand side of the equation is the force applied due to the pressure inside the cylinder. It is given by pressure into area. This pressure will act on a rectangular area having width di and length l. On the right hand side, we get the resisting force offered by the material, which is nothing but strength of the material into area of the material. Area of the material is thickness of the material into the length of the cylinder. We have such two cross sections resisting the failure, hence the number 2 will appear in this equation. If we rearrange this equation, we will get tangential or circumferential stress in the cylinder given by pi di upon 2t. The second failure mode exists along the circumference of a cylinder. In this failure mode, the cylinder will fail like a cucumber in which the knife is passing perpendicular to the axis of cucumber, or we can also say that it is passing in a transverse direction. The cause of this failure is the longitudinal stress induced into the material of the cylinder. Again, the equilibrium equation can be written in this fashion. On the left hand side is the force applied by the pressure, and on the right hand side we have resisting force applied by or offered by the material. On the left hand side we have pressure into area through which the pressure is acting. In this case, this area is a circular cross section, hence it is given by pi by 4 di square. On the right hand side we have strength of the material into area of the material. In this case, the area is an annular ring which is shown by gray region. This area is approximately equal to circumference of this circle multiplied by thickness of the cylinder. This assumption is quite valid because in this case thickness is a very small quantity. By rearranging these terms, we can say that longitudinal stress is equal to pi di upon 4t. If we compare these two equations of tangential stress and longitudinal stress, we will realize that tangential stress for the same value of pressure, diameter and thickness, it's twice as compared to the longitudinal stress. Hence, in case of thin cylinders, tangential stress is more severe as compared to the longitudinal stress. Hence, we can write the formula for thickness of a thin cylinder based on the tangential stress, and it is given by T equal to pi di upon 2 sigma t. We can extend this discussion for calculating stresses in spherical vessels. Spherical vessels are subjected to circumferential failure. In this type of failure, it will look like a coconut which is broken into two halves. The cause of this failure is longitudinal stress, and therefore this equation of equilibrium holds true. Hence, we get longitudinal stress equal to pi di upon 4t in case of spherical vessels. Therefore, we can write that thickness of a spherical vessel is equal to pi di upon 4 sigma l. If we compare thickness of cylindrical vessel with thickness of a spherical vessel for same value of pressure, internal diameter, then we realize that the thickness of the spherical vessel will be half as compared to thickness of a cylindrical vessel. Therefore, we can have a huge amount of saving in material. However, as far as space efficiency is concerned, for the same volume, the space occupied by the spherical pressure vessel will be very high. Hence, it is not practical to use spherical pressure vessel due to the inefficiency in occupying the space. Let us consider one numerical example to understand this formula. A seamless cylinder of storage capacity 0.025 m cube made up of alloy steel 20 moly 55 having ultimate tensile strength of 500 newton per mm square is to be used to store a fluid at 15 megapascal gauge pressure. The length of cylinder is twice its inner diameter. If the factor of safety is 2, determine the cylinder dimensions. Given data can be extracted from this problem statement. The formula for calculating the thickness of a cylinder is given by pi di upon 2 sigma all. In this formula, sigma t is replaced by sigma all, which is nothing but allowable stress. Its value can be given by ultimate tensile strength divided by factor of safety. Another unknown in this formula is inner diameter of a cylinder. However, volume of a cylinder is known to you, and formula for volume of a cylinder is pi by 4 di square l. In this formula, there are two unknowns such as di and l, but we know there exists a relationship between di and l. Thus, there is only one unknown in this equation, and volume is known, and we can calculate inner diameter and length of a cylinder as 255 mm and 510 mm respectively. By putting all these known terms in this equation, thickness of a cylinder can be calculated as 7.65 mm, which is approximately equal to 8 mm. Finally, a ratio of di upon t is calculated, which comes out to be 31.875, which is greater than 20, and hence the assumption at the beginning of the problem that this will be a thin cylinder is true, and the problem is solved. Thank you.